I, John Hsu.
And I, Lily Gehring, as student council co-presidents, welcome you to the 2020 graduation ceremony. Although we each have accomplished amazing things throughout our time here, none of this would be possible without our loving parents. They made sure we caught the bus in the morning or made sure we arrived at school on time. They drove us to every sports practice, game, or extracurricular activities. Without our parents' decision to send us to St. Michael's, we wouldn't have made special memories with the people we will never forget. So, as you are handed your diploma, thank them and tell them you love them. They shaped us into the young adults we are today. St. Michael's has left an impact on all of our lives, whether we have realized it or not. The friends we've made over the years are the ones who will stay in our hearts forever.
In preschool, with Mrs. Loader, we spent our days napping and learning how to count. In kindergarten with Ms. Hudeck, we learned the alphabet with the letter and ate ice from the ice cream truck. In first grade, we gained our competitiveness with the SRA reading books in Mrs. Lindsay's class and raced to see who could finish the test first in Mrs. Biedenbach's. In second grade, we received our first communion and first reconciliation under the guidance of Mrs. Manning and Mrs. Lexko. In third grade, we sang Beach Boys with Mrs. Stoliker until we lost our voices and collected bottle caps as we welcomed Mrs. Cyber to her first year at SMS. In fourth grade, we talked about sports and Star Wars with Mr. Earhart for hours upon hours and laughed with Miss Beck until our stomachs hurt. In fifth grade, we made the whole classroom smell like smoke and got water sprayed on us by Mrs. Regula, while Mrs. Stoliker taught us math for the third year in a row. In sixth grade, we said goodbye to a handful of some of our best friends, but with open arms welcomed many more. Mrs. Miller taught us the basics of Monopoly, but Mrs. Santon pushed us to our limits during math class, while stopping to have fun and play cards with us at Camp Muskingum. All of a sudden, we reached seventh grade. Mrs. Krajek taught us that just about anything can be turned into a song, but also pushed us to become amazing writers and saw potential in all of us. Mrs. Stu Miller welcomed her second child and let us name him while still managing to teach us about Edgar Allan Poe. And New York City created some of the best memories of our lives. And finally, eighth grade, Mrs. Cannell and Mrs. Farron have been our rocks through it all. We learned about the functions of plasma and the whole circulatory system, which we could probably recite in our sleep. We most likely wouldn't survive the Oregon Trail because we could barely do it in a video game.
Some of us can remember in kindergarten looking up at the class of 2012 thinking, wow, I cannot wait to be them. And here we are, we made it. Although this isn't what we dreamed and wished our graduation would be like, we're still here. Nothing, not even a global pandemic, can stop us from having our special day. Although, if St. Michael's has taught us anything, it's that God is always here for us. He has been there through our toughest moments and happiest days. In our community and at school, Jesus has been a large part of our lives, and we will not give that up. Whether we are continuing our Catholic education or going to a public high school, we know God will never leave any of us. On behalf of the 2020 eighth grade graduating class, we would like to give a big thank you to our wonderful teachers, Ms. Gaddy, Father Benson, Father Zachary, Mrs. Herbst, Mrs. Clark, Senora Davis, and every single staff member who has watched us grow up throughout the years. And especially a huge thank you to our classmates. Each and every one of us should be proud of who we are and what we have accomplished throughout our time at SMS. We have given one another the experience of a lifetime. We have watched one another grow up and achieve some amazing accomplishments. Through the ups, the downs, the singing, the dancing, the laughing until we couldn't breathe, and even the tears, we are ready to say goodbye to St. Michael's. Thank you.
My dear friends, let us begin this celebration by inviting Almighty God to be in our midst and guide and direct us as we begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Lord God, thank you for this special day. Be with us as we celebrate the achievements of St. Michael's School Class of 2020. Come to be with us as we honor them and celebrate them and send them off to go out and continue with their education in high school. May you be with us all. Help us each day to work more closely with you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The loving deeds of the Lord I will recall, the glorious acts of the Lord, because of all the Lord has done for us, the immense goodness to the house of Israel, which he has granted according to his mercy and his many loving deeds. He said, "They are indeed my people, children who are not disloyal." So he became their savior in their every affliction. It was not an envoy or a messenger, but his presence that saved them. Because of his love and pity, the Lord redeemed them, lifting them up and carrying them all the days of old. The word of the Lord.
Shine upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. Thus, they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, graduation is a rite of passage in our world, in our society, in our country. Every student looks forward to the day of graduation with excitement. It is a day filled with joy, gladness for the graduates, for the achievements. It is a happy day for proud parents and grandparents, relatives of the graduates, and for the teachers who taught them. Families and friends usually gather in the auditorium or in the church to cheer the graduates as the principal calls each by name and describes the accomplishments and their attributes. The teachers of these graduates prepare the day by drilling the students for hours upon hours so that they can carry off the pageantry of the big day without stumbling on the stage. My dear friends, I am quite sure that you graduates are missing this fun part of today's ceremony. Your teachers and the whole St. Michael School family miss that too. I am sure your parents, grandparents, friends, and family who would have loved to be here present as your greatest cheerleaders miss that also. However, even though that part of the ceremony is important and is missing, I want you not to allow that to rob you the most important part of this ceremony. And that is that you have achieved a great milestone. This achievement is the beginning of the journey and not the end. There will be many more milestones to be achieved and celebrated in your lives. Here at St. Michael's School, you excelled intellectually. You made good grades. You passed your test. And now you are destined to continue your education in high school. However, beyond that intellectual achievement and your social growth, please remember that St. Michael's School exists for one reason, which is beyond reading, writing, and math. That reason is to share with you our Catholic faith, our hope of eternal life, and our experience of God's love for you and your love for God. Please remember St. Michael's as your spiritual home. I know, because I hope I will see you at Mass every weekend. And I plead with you to stay close to your God and your Catholic faith by remaining active participants in our parish family. I invite you, if you have not already done so, to be part of our youth ministry. Remember always that we are all called to live a life doing the will of our Heavenly Father. The question is, how do we live a life of doing the will of our Heavenly Father? The answer is simple, and that answer is given in today's gospel, the Beatitudes, where Jesus gives his followers a roadmap to a happy eternity. All the saints in heaven walked the narrow path of the Beatitude to arrive at the heavenly bliss. The Beatitudes propose to us a way of life, inviting us to identify with the poor, with those who are sorrowful, with the meek, and with those who hunger and thirst for justice. They challenge us to be compassionate people, to be men and women who are pure in heart, and to become peacemakers in our dealings with one another, in our families, in our society at large. Even when this approach to things exposes us to ridicule and persecution, St. Michael's School has laid a good foundation and a solid one for you to live this life of the Beatitude in a world that is in so much need of people who are living the life of the Beatitude. To you parents and grandparents, I want to express on behalf of the teachers and staff of St. Michael's School our sincerest appreciation and thanks. I thank you for the faith and love you share with your families. We know at great expense you chose St. Michael as your partner in teaching your children in the ways of faith. I am speaking the minds of our graduates if I make bold to say on their behalf that they are very thankful and appreciative for the sacrifices you made to give them 8 years of Catholic education. Finally, my prayer to all of us is that we continue to grow in faith and love, and continue to develop the gifts and the talents God has given us by living the life of the Beatitudes. Congratulations, our beloved graduates.
Central Catholic High School Education Foundation awards scholarships and grants based on previous grades, activities, recommendations, and the results of their ACT test administered last November. The competition was huge, and I am very proud to say that four of our eighth grade graduates have been awarded the scholarship. A $500 tuition grant, renewable every year of enrollment at Central Catholic High School, goes to Madison Heiser and Sydney Turner. A $250 Alois Winner Memorial Scholarship, renewable yearly throughout enrollment at Central Catholic, goes to Josie Stevens and Julia Biedenbaum. The following awards were chosen from 10 faculty members that taught our eighth grade students this year. The Arts and Stewardship Award. This award is a service award. It is given to students who led our school this year in music, voice, and volunteerism. St. Michael's School music program and school masses were very much enriched by their commitment and talents. Our gratitude and congratulations goes to Olivia Gosney and Gabrielle Steele. St. Michael Citizen Award. The fourth annual St. Michael the Archangel Citizen Award is being given to two students. This student has always demonstrated a strong Christian spirit and respect for teachers and classmates. Both of these students who receive this award strived to excel in many of our extracurricular activities. These include participation in academics, sports teams, and service. The first student earned high academic honors for all four quarters. He is a member of student council. He is our Geography B champion, earning a place in the Geography B state competition. He always was recognized with various writing awards. We give our congratulations to Jonas Jacob. The second St. Michael Citizen Award recipient has earned high academic honors for all four quarters, was a leader in more than one of our sports teams. She also excels as a writing winner, the very prestigious Gold Key. Her writing qualified her for the Power of the Pen state competition. I am very proud to say this award goes to Josie Stevens. The Monsignor Halter Award. It is the most prestigious given to selected members of the eighth grade. We look for students who exemplify the ideals of St. Michael's School by striving for high academic achievement, participation in extracurricular activities, and serving the school and community with respect and Christian values. The female student who received this award maintained high academic honors quarterly, is respectful to both teachers and staff, was a leader on our volleyball team. Her writing earned various awards, including the prestigious Silver Key and Power of the Pen regional qualification. Her kindness and generosity were always present in the classroom. I am very proud to say this award goes to Madison Heiser. The male student to receive this award maintained high academic honors quarterly. He was respectful, appreciative, and frequently acknowledged faculty as religious commissioner. He took his duties very seriously. He volunteered to make our school environment strong and participated in athletics. His writing earned an honorable mention in the Scholastic Writing Program, and last year earned the prestigious Scholastic Silver Medal. He was a constant model of tenacity, leadership, and accomplishment. I am proud to say this award goes to Michael Woodward. A few years ago, we began a new award, the Tommy Domotor Scholarship. This scholarship is not based on financial need. It is given to an eighth grade student who will be going to Central Catholic High School. This scholarship is for $500 each year for 4 years, a total of $2,000. The student who will receive this award is a service leader and student council member. Received high honors quarterly. Always strive to make St. Michael School better by example as a kind, thoughtful, and creative leader. And in the spirit of Tommy Domotor, is Christian-like and tolerant of others. This scholarship goes to Timmy Sieber. All of these students have worked hard to earn these awards, and we honor them and we thank them for being part of St. Michael's School. It is my honor to award diplomas to the following students: Julia Celeste Biedenbaugh, Layla Rose Brandon, Ella Grace Bullock, Caroline Rose Crane, Giovanni Leonard DeSabato, Emery Gage Evans, Elise Falte, Ella Rose Frabata, Kyle David Furby, Lily Angeline Gehring, Olivia Rose Gosney, Madison Elizabeth Heiser, Katie J. Hout, Christian Javier Icaza, Jonas William Jacob, Serena Kelly Langenfield, Zoe N. Marsh, Ava Isabella Mioli. Marcello Nicholas Mioli. J. Benedict Morrow. Lucas Joseph Nazvedi. Tanner Michael Perkins. John Charles Hsu. Timothy George Sieber, Jr. Gabrielle Elizabeth Pearl Steele. Josie Ann Stevens. Landon Robert Thrower. Sydney Catherine Turner. Michael K. Vallone. Michael Robert Woodward. On behalf of all of the teachers and staff, and Father Benson and Father Zachary, we would like to congratulate all the 2020 graduates of St. Michael School.
Please, may we stand for the petitions as we rely on the giver of peace. Let us lift up our prayers to the Lord.
For the church throughout the world, may we continue to be the salt of the earth and light for the world, we pray.
Lord, hear prayer.
For teachers, administrators, and all who work in schools, may they continue to trust in the seed they've planted and never become discouraged by the work they do. We pray.
Lord, hear prayer.
For the graduating class of 2020, may God bless them through these trying times, and may they always value their faith with friendship, compassion, and service to others. We pray.
Lord, hear prayer.
For all students, especially our St. Michael School students, may they never tire of learning as they continue to grow in wisdom and strength, we pray.
Lord, hear prayer.
For all those who struggle with school and those who are persecuted or bullied, may the Spirit of God lift them up from their despair and fill them with hope, we pray.
Lord, hear prayer.
For those among us who are sick, for Bishop Murray in his continued fight with leukemia, for all those affected by the coronavirus and chronic illnesses, may they find respite in God's peace, we pray.
Lord, hear prayer.
For our parents and our families whose love and care have been an inspiration to us, and for our family members who have been called home to heaven, may they rejoice in God's never-ending light, we pray.
Lord, hear prayer. Lord our God, you call us to be peacemakers. Accept these prayers and fill us with your peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. As we keep standing, I invite you together, let us call God our Father by the prayer Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. All graduates, please bow down your heads and pray for God's blessing. Good and gracious God, In your wisdom and love, you surround us with the mysteries of the universe. In times long past, you sent us your prophets to teach your laws and to bear witness to your undying love. You sent us your Son to teach us by word and example that the true wisdom comes from you alone. Send your Spirit upon these students, our graduates, and fill them with wisdom and blessing. As they are ending their studies here at St. Michael, let them remember what they have learned and never get tired of learning new things. Father, guide them on their journey that they may continue to be the salt of the earth. Grant that they may follow Christ Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life forever and ever. Amen. May God teach you his ways and lead you to the joys of his kingdom now and forever. Amen. And Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations once again.
Into the darkness and created the light. Our God is an awesome God. The truth he poured out of Sodom, the mercy and grace he gave us at the cross. Hope that he wants so better be believing that our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wings of power and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns.
All the world is ours, and this world is so bright. You and I sharing this time together, sharing the same dream. As time goes by,
times we had, I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side. When nobody could hold us down, we claimed the brightest star, and we came so far, and no, they won't forget. Yeah. Whenever you
to
proud when you look back and see how far we've come. It was our time to shine, and nobody could hold us down. They thought they'd see us fall, but we stood so tall, and no.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.